gonna be alright. Look at me. Tell me, what do you see when you look at me? I'm finally free. I like those chicks called problems. They make me feel better than ever. I drove that Rolls Royce over Ferrari. Got any feel better than ever. I don't know him better than ever. I take the drugs while it's so steep. Have me feeling better than ever.
Traffic, can't hesitate. About my books, no Tampa Bay. If it ain't about you, can't conversate. I can't kick it with these niggas. I don't play soft. shit power.
Let me pop my sheet, let me pop my sheet.
Yeah.
Let me pop my sheet, let me pop my sheet.
We got plenty, baby. Ain't no damn shortage. I got that shit on. I'm Miss Chrome Heart with Supreme Forces.
Let me pop my sheet. Let me pop my sheet.
Yeah.
Let me pop my sheet. Let me pop my sheet.
I can't talk business on the phone. Nigga, phone might be top. Spent 600 on the shirt because I had a good day in the trial.
Yeah. Let me pop my sheet. Let me pop my sheet.
Yeah.
Let me pop my sheet. Bro. Let me pop my sheet.
Bitch, I'm big old three. Big old shit popper.
Yeah.
These niggas ain't really gangsters. They be dick popping. I can finesse my plug. Uncle Zodum got me slick talking. I just got off a dub. This Louis sweater, she biting the drip off her. SRT, hit the gas and it jerk, feel like it's kickstarted. Ice my wrist, brand new paddock watch. This shit like six corners. Super turn, my shit costs a brick. I feel like Rich Porter. Icebox getting cleaning. My shit dirty, it look like flip water. Casablanca shades sitting on my fade. Let me pop my shit. Off white shirt ain't beige. It look like some grits.
Shirt ain't beige.
Stem filled up with cane. Watch him take a hit.
Call me and say he wanted a dub. That's
major
lit.
I can't kick it with these niggas. I don't play solving. Bitch, I'm big soft, big old shit popping.
Let me pop my sheet. Let me pop my sheet.
Yeah.
Let me pop my sheet. Let me pop my sheet.
We got plenty, baby. Ain't no damn shortage. I got that shit on. I'm Miss Chrome Heart with Supreme Forces.
Let me pop my sheet. Let me pop my sheet.
Yeah.
Let me pop my sheet. Let me pop my sheet.
I can't talk business on the phone. Nigga, phone might be top. Spent 600 on the shirt because I had a good day in the trial.
Yeah.
Let me pop my sheet. Let me pop my sheet.
Yeah.
Let me pop my sheet. Let me pop my sheet.
Yeah. Nigga. Slam dunk on you, fuck nigga, nigga. Yeah. Nigga. Kind of trolling on my page. Got me scared to drive a pig. On the plug, put me on. I got that shit on quick. I remember I was on my dick. Me and Dre robbing the lead. Put the nigga piss me off. I'ma really pop my shit. Yeah. Put a big one on these hoes, baby. Don't even touch me, I spit the grip for these clothes, baby. My trap stay open, it'll never close, baby. I'm a fat nigga, you know I love my stove, baby. Come on, baby, let's get this chicken. We got good small, no biggie. Purple shorts, light 250. I'm too motherfucking slippery. I just left out Lenny, man. Do the market, no JCPenney. I can't cover bitch, these hoes too motherfucking friendly. I ain't never turn myself in, do your job, bitch, come fine.
Come on,
I pull up presidential. I feel like Joe Biden. All my niggas know it's motion. Nigga be looking like a lion.
Motion.
I don't know who D-Lo is, but that fuck nigga be sliding. Kind of trolling on my page. Got me scared to drive a pig. Soon as the plug put me on, I got that shit on quick. I remember I was on my dick. Me and Dre robbing the lean. Put the nigga piss me off, I'ma really pop my shit. Yeah. Put a big one on these hoes, baby. Don't even touch me. I spin the grip for these clothes, baby. My trap stay open. It'll never close, baby. I'm a fat nigga. You know I love my stove, baby.
Stove, baby.
I need the quickest car. I got zips of white rust in the cookie jar. Roll the wet shit from the corner like a shooting guard. I'm tearing up the city in that strike a corner bend. Call play me 350, give me 15 minutes. Put your wrist all in the bowl, gotta put your shoulder in it. I could bust open some load, got a strong load in it. Fuck her from the back, slap her ass, let her know I'm in it. All these bags in the car, shit like some groceries in it. Pull up a Beamer truck, M Sport motor in it. Dark tinted rental truck, put the good shoulders in it. Dope ain't looking right, too much bacon soda in it. Nigga fought the penitentiary, got the real soldiers in it. It's a drug dealer committed, came up on rocks and bowls. I wouldn't be a fuck thing without them pots and stove.
Yeah.
Beating up that road, got my fucking pocket swole.
Back.
I got whatever a nigga need, just draw the load.
Yeah.
Pull up GLE 63 Mercedes. Mercedes, nigga, the shopper, cause a dope game crazy. Okay, keep track clean, case they raid it.
Okay.
I walk out of bitch like I'm David, nigga.
Bitch, I'm beat is off.
In case them crackers hit the lights, I need the quickest car. I got zips of white rust in the cookie jar. Brody wet shit from the corner like a shooting guard. I'm tearing up the city in that strike a corner bennet. Call play me 350, give me 15 minutes. Put your wrist all in the bowl, gotta put your shoulder in it. I can bust open some load, got a strong load in it.
Bitch, I'm beat is off.
Hit the lights, I need the quickest car. A white rinse in a cookie jar. Throw the wet shit like a shooting guard.
You like a rat. Racks all in my jeans, baby. Got a pocket full of rat. I'm all about my cheese, baby. I ain't doing no going flat. Bees all bay, they loving that. I ain't beef by hoes, no none of that. Trap on doing job and jet. Pull up in the wood, is that? I'm a real street nigga. I'm posted on 46. Bad bitch, her ass fat. She walk like she know she thick. I'm balling hard, I'm MVP. I look like the PNC. I could be right in the nigga face. Pussy nigga ain't seeing me. Get in motion, stop the violence. Big pressure, I'm applying it. Don't even touch me, it's designer. Boy, that fuck nigga, that be slime. Man, with all that flow shit, I gotta keep that shit from rhyming. I was a kid skipping school, smoking weed, breaking the highs. I'm Big Zai. I can't smoke nothing but the lies. Get it for a set of a year, I'll make a thousand. I've been a corner, something nice with low mileage. I'm driving too fast in this bitch, nigga. I'm white. Bees all day, they loving that. I ain't beef by hoes, no none of that. Trap on doing jumping jack. Pull up in the wood, is that? Let me grab that ass, baby. She like, yeah, I know it's fat. You got a ass, baby. I'ma spoil you like a rat. Racks all in my jeans, baby. Got a pocket full of rat. I'm all about my cheese, baby. I ain't doing no going flat. Bees all day, they loving that. I ain't beef by hoes, no none of that. Trap on doing jumping jack. Pull up in the wood, is that?
Trap on doing push up. Better crack it in the kitchen, watch a nigga cook All this I got, nigga, too late.
I ain't going for nothing, little bitch, you crazy.
I'm fucked up bad, I swear my lady.
I'm fucked up bad, I swear no gas. I'm skipping the cats in 23. Yeah. They going out bad, I'm doing the dance. I'm hoping no crazy, you driving me crazy.
I'm stuck in the fat lane. Yeah. Breaking their back, giving back pain. Step on the knee, take crush. For the ride, shotgun in front seat.
I rode the part on the bus. I cannot make this shit up.
These all bad, they loving that. I ain't beef my hoes on none of that. Trap on doing job and jack. Pull up in the wooded back. Let me grab that ass, baby. She like, yeah, I know it's that. He ain't got a ass, baby. I'ma spoil you like a brat. Racks all in my jeans, baby. Got a pocket full of racks. I'm all about my cheese, baby. I ain't doing no going flat. These all bad, they loving that. I ain't beef my hoes on none of that. Trap on doing job and jack. Pull up in the wooded back.
Enjoy a sample of Dangerous
Violence.
Now back to your music.
Diamonds on me dancing, pink ring full of crystals, babe. Niggas out in the building, come and take a picture, babe. Y'all nigga poppin' shit, you know I'm that nigga, babe. Wrist piece on bling blow, neck piece on blizzard, babe.
I throw some ones, baby, you do that dance on me, babe. I throw 1,000 low keep shaking that ass on me, babe. Y'all nigga round around with him.
I can tell by that fake that these niggas really creep. I keep on buying
my wigs. I'm sorry I cheated on you, boo. But gee, my pockets look like a stuffed with a shoe. Don't leave my messages on red. Got money coming out the blue. Double R, I got her hanging out the motherfucking roof. Don't piss me off, I got a button behind a 17. Get money, my mama told me eat my collard greens. Jump out in that wide by that money, bitch, I slide by it. Better I slap five by the bitches, they gon' cry about me.
Anything you do, but bitch, you don't tell on a nigga, y'all do it, y'all. Tore up out you, fuck you, yeah.
But y'all don't appreciate my presence.
Hey, when I put it on your lip, quiet, I still...
You just do this. You change your perception on life. Everybody you see do that, and know you there, you do that. And it changes everybody's perception of life. Whether you know they see you or don't see you, or know they see you or they don't, you should. If you see them, you see them. They might give you high-tech glasses, you might not even like high-tech. But the difference is, your blessings. And knowing how to count your blessings like counting your money. Since I was a kid, knowing numbers, I knew how to count. Before I even went to preschool in 1995, when I was born in 1991, went to preschool at a 4-year age. Preschool as a 4-year old. Graduated from high school, valedictorian, A plus honor roll, filling in the blanks as an English teacher. And it's all, you know what I'm saying, reading paper, and then filling in the blanks, you know what I'm saying, writing for yourself, you're saying, you know what I'm saying, people had to have it on the top, they were turning the ear around. You know, when the teacher said, take that hat off, you didn't know how to put it on your legs. Your left leg, yep. And put your glasses, and she'd be like, don't put your glasses on because it might be paper on, not knowing that you got it on your head, but you're not supposed to reach it. And you'd be like, I need to put my glasses, the smart people do that, and put their glasses on their head. And all right, I'm ready for the test. Instead of a cigarette, they have a pen in their hands. They try to cap them, say that I put this in script school with two Trump supporters. I graduated from college in 1999. 14 years of school. 14 years of school. Literally 14 years. I was high school valedictorian. 14. Preschool, 1995. I was born 1991, September 12th. As a 4-year-old. Because I started school in August, a month before my birthday. Yes, four. And I was really what age? Dun dun dun. Ooh, yeah. Calculate that. I was a 3-year-old valedictorian in preschool. Y'all ready? Yeah, reading and writing, I already knew that. I was a perfectionist. I perfected it. I learned it again. I learned how to write it perfectionist. My handwriting was like a doctor. 3-year-old. Turning for in preschool. Facts, 1995. Because I was born 1991. 4 years after that is 1995. If you can count, okay? I could, because my little brother was born in 1995, so I knew how old I was of him. John Depp, my brother, living a little bit today. Thank God. Right now. He didn't know age, let's see, two, about $10, and picking up 10 pieces of trash, because I can't look up and down to the future. But the labor, he didn't know manual labor, let alone money, because he was 2 years old, he didn't understand. I was, let's see, 1997, I was 6 years old. This is when I was in kindergarten. A year later, I was in kindergarten. My stepdad, my real dad, I called my stepdad. I think it was my dad. I don't know why. Stepdad, my dad, John Johnson. He was like, hey, AJ, you want to pick up these pieces of trash in the yard before I cut the grass for $10? I'm like, yeah, sure, that's $10, bro. Because I'm thinking to myself, I'm getting trash. I'm going to cut grass myself. This is just picking up trash. And while I'm going through the trash, he gives me a bag to pick up the trash as I go through the yard. Front to back on Duncan Street, I pick up the trash. I count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I do a full circle around the house. And then go back. I do a dad and I picked up all the trash. I think I said daddy picked up all the trash. I gave him a drag of trash. I was like, all right, here's another $10. He gave me $10 just like that. I was like, thank God. Now I can buy something to eat. I can go to the store. I don't know. Next thing you know, I don't know which one I'm going to do. So next thing you know, I went in the house, he cut the grass, and he came back. And I said, you know, he's like, man, I'm hungry from all that grass. Like, man, what's in there to eat? Like, man, I gave AJ that $10. I wish I could buy this $5.99 pizza, two for $5.99. $5.99. I was like, daddy, I got $10 that you gave me. I saved it. And I got some change in this crayon box. I mean the pencil box. Next thing you know, I went and got the $10. He called Domino's over $2.99. After a while they showed up. He said, AJ, you got that $10? The pizza man, he was like, ran to the back of the room, got a $10, gave it to my dad. He was like, here you go. He's like, it's about $12 and some change. He's like, I don't even got no change. And he looked at me and smiled. He's like, you know, I got that change in my life. I went back there, had the change, had the exact change. He was like, 15 cents left in nickels. First time I ever bought pizza for the whole house. Daddy. My mama, John Dale, Shay, me, and Claire was about to be there. Claire was either a month from being born or a year before I was being born. All I know is that I blessed me by pizza for all 5 of us. And it was a blessing. It was the first time I ever bought it at age six. I felt good. It was like kindergarten. The first time I ever bought pizza for my entire family, working hard. And it was basically not working hard. It was like a smarter, not harder. My real father taught me that before he even taught me that. Got to sixth grade and had a retirement plan. He was asking me, they pulled in the class and asked me, what am I going to do? What's my retirement plan? And I'm like, what? And is this enough? Have you do some paperwork, but what do I choose to do after graduating high school? Sixth grade. I bullshit you not. I ain't middle school. They had me in the hallway talking about what do I want to watch my choice for retirement after graduating high school. Basically, no, I didn't fail. They passed me about the time in sixth grade for choosing marine biology and being a fisherman. All it took was 2 years of college to be a marine biologist. I graduated high school in sixth grade, A plus only. I graduated. I was in my grandma Rose house. Read the dictionary. You would learn everything from the dictionary. She said, I know who I am. So I looked for my first name and didn't find shit, but I read that old dictionary because I was a kid, didn't know my name wasn't in the dictionary. I knew the last name was there in the middle, but I didn't know nothing else. So I read everything to Zenith. Top 20 of your career, retired and college graduate. College. Damn. Got the high school, they was like, we don't know what to do with you. I was going to high school, they don't have my grade, they was going to school, and I was not trying to be funny, they never talked about me the whole time, because I was a ninth grade, it hit me, that one, I was a 10th grade, they put me out of school for two grades, sent me back to Kansas City, went to North Carolina, graduated, one after entry test, 10th grade till 11th, I was supposed to be at age 16. Saying I was 18, for sure. Next thing you know, they realized I didn't even graduate. I had to move, so they shut down the school. Everybody's there. 39th percentile. Shit. Or prospect, whichever one. Shit. Everybody.
She smiled at me, she said, I cried, she said,
That's when they were trying to roast them too. That's why we say tweaked out. They do powder, they fished out, and they did tweaked out. Cure your mind, you gotta free your thoughts of walls. To truly achieve the breath and blessing. It's not about believing in God. It's not about believing in that. Anybody can get this. And do this. Anybody can get this. Or this. Or this. It depends on how that would be. Jesus, though. I called upon Jesus when I walked home. I didn't get hit in the It was when I was out there with the niggas, though. I was going to cut the motherfucker down before doing it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I ain't kill him, though.
Damn.
That ain't for the case, though. That wasn't what the case was about. The case, the murder case that I was put into was because I got shot in the neck with a BB gun. And then somebody said something to me. I used to fuck with kids on the road. They were going over a car and took a picture with me in the car. The only picture I took with her.
Jesus.
To a friend for conspiracy, force, my side. I used to be 195 pounds. I played football. Now I'm 150. Damn. It's 150 pounds. I was 147. I lived here for about 2 months. I gained about 5-6 pounds. I weighed myself now probably 153. And I'm still eating. Thing to it's her brother. She ain't on the head wall, but what happened to Virgil? So I think type door down. I step on top of on the same dirty model or dirty magnet. That's good. But I wonder why you do what you do. Call me that way. I told my brother, she popped me in the eye one time with a plastic baby gun. And I was like, it's protection from security compared to insecurity. That's why I was saying I'm not a security because I'm an insecurity. I'm not a security. My security is good. For me, protecting my security, or securing myself and my own life is the difference. That's the difference. I teach my kids how to protect themselves and their life. Let alone become smart enough to be a high school graduate team. But the only thing is they have insecurities because they're hard. They want to be perfect. Not everybody can draw a long release list. It's okay. They can draw a long release. But I bet you I can read the word long release. Perfect moment. And then you guys want to spell it out. Spell it out for you right now. You want to be able to read the word release. Jeez. Don't even worry about that. I was ragging up the phone on somebody. She was screaming at me. What's her name? Pamela Anderson. They wonder why I keep playing. You don't want me to get to the black. Oh, it's a freaking pictures, but I know when the sheep in the sheep. You a kid trying to kiss me? Don't lie. Get out of here. Hey, that's your kid. Get your ass to your mama. She gonna whip your ass. Lord, forgive me. He'll forgive me if you don't. Sleeve on my hoodie. Shit. Went to drop the other side. He ran up, tried to grab me. I put my hoodie around. Shit. He had to grab me and slam me into the locker. And I pushed him off. I hit my forehead and my face on the locker. And my left eye. And next thing you know, he ran up, caught me with two to the left cheek. And all I know is I wrapped up his shirt and caught him with three. Boom, boom. That third one I caught back. Like I was dunking on his your A up, and he hit him, and then told him round off, all three of them had to drag him around the corner and hit him in the bathroom, because he was TKO. I couldn't believe it, first time I ever knocked somebody out, gave him three punches and he knocked down. I couldn't believe it. I hit him so hard that he pushed. I moved his I hit him in the chin. Body couldn't do nothing. Push yourself. Turn his whole body. His whole body. Turn the opposite direction. Yeah. Just finished. 12 to 12. Cracked him. Boom. Yeah. He fell down. Yeah. Stood up and started walking back. We got a big block. Chin knees. Next thing you know, I got him before. He was flattened. He had to bang him back with six. Preaching to my people on the other gospel. Anybody can say yes and say that. Anybody can try this and try that. And what the difference is, God will make us prosper. Because all we have is money. People do drugs and think it's a video of that. We only got one life. Understand? One life is like everybody can be so judgmental about to themselves. They know they're lying. They got to try and judge the next person. They try and God the next person lying. You can instigate. That is why God might instigate. When they know they're lying, and everybody else knows they're lying, they find they don't know. The difference is the people can stop it before it happens. Instead of waiting till it happens and then see an outcome and then say, see what you got out of it. No, you can stop it before they even listen to it. They know that. All of them know that. The difference is if they choose to stop that, most of them don't care. And so it would be so judgmental. And just want to lash out with violence and show them righteous and stop it before it even happens. And then when I say that, they think they're trying to get rid of the you know what. But I ain't gonna mention that. You can give a manifest, teach a manifest, but you can lead a horse to water, but you can't make it drink. I mean, you can teach people a way of changing, but the choice is theirs to change if they want to or not. A lot of people are like, man, I don't care. And you don't care, that's the difference. I care. That's where you can change and care too. Anybody can make the choice to not care, give up, because they know they can give up and not care, live day by day. You can make the choice to never give up and prosper every day and achieve, let alone make the choice to give up so easily and lose your life in the process. You can be starving every day. You can eat something every day. You can eat insulin every day. You can have diabetes, basically. You'll die. That day, first day, second day, whatever day, you don't have insulin, it's medicine. That's medicine for one. Let alone having a kid that needs that. That's two. Let alone your mother or father that brought you in this world. That's three. You see the difference? You see the difference? Your kid, yourself, your mother, father, your parents. Brother, cousin, aunt, uncle. I choose to care about the family that I have. The people that don't choose to care, they don't care. Y'all wouldn't sacrifice a dollar for your little alcohol shop for a diabetes patient to pay you a dollar on their diabetes insulin in a year, trying to live. They wouldn't. They didn't ask to be that way. They was born that way. They body was born to be that way. They was born that way. No matter how much your body changed, how much you grow hair, get your hair cut, your body is born to do that. Your body will never change what it's born to do. Your heart will never stop pumping blood till it dies. Your brain will never stop thinking until it's dead. Your organs will not stop working until it's dead. You was born with the same organs that you was born with. Your body is made to do what it does for you. It is not to overdo, let alone over-attempt. That's why we only have energy spans of what a day. Exactly. Our energy spans is different, let alone our functions. Brain functions, heart functions, lung functions, etc. Why? The weight on our shoulders. We wasn't made to live forever.